Yep, I love E3 because of all the games and all that, but I love it more because I get to spend time with Rod Ferguson from the Coalition. How are you, mate?
Good, how are you?
Wonderful to see you, as always.
You too, lovely shirt.
Thank you. Yeah, look at us.
I know. Like, it looks wonderful. Twins activate.
That's good.
But you got to be form of water. I want to be the animal one. You got to be the pail of water that gets pulled around all the time.
Very good. All right. Hey. Congratulations on the show and on stage yesterday.
Thank you. Amazing
moment for Gears. Not one Gears game, but no. Three.
Yeah, overachievers. We're a Coalition of overachievers. We're like, anybody can do one announce. Let's do three announces. So.
No, that was fantastic. Great moment on the stage back there. Let's start with the third game you announced, right? Gears 5.
Okay.
Talk to us about the world of Gears 5, and I would love to know more about Kate. Is she actually the protagonist of Gears 5?
She is, yeah. Okay. Kate is the main protagonist for the game. Basically, you know, it was just a natural, when you play through Gears 4, you know, I think of it as sort of what you think of with Mad Max Fury Road. You know, it was like, really, it was Furiosa's story, but Mad Max, like, Max was the sort of the sidekick in that story, even though it was called Mad Max. And it kind of felt that way when you look at Kate. The whole game is about saving Kate's mom, and really, JD is there to help her. And so, when we talked about doing the next game, it was really made sense that Kate should actually step in, and you should play as her as she continues this journey of discovery about, like, why do I have this connection to the Locust? What's going on? And what's happening to me right now? And so we really wanted you to put the player sort of in the driver's seat.
We saw Kate traversing these amazing, like, frozen wastelands.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit more about the world that she's venturing out into and where she's maybe going a little bit.
Yeah, well, for us, it was all about having the biggest and most beautiful world we've ever made. And that the reason we did that in the trailer was really just to show an example of some of the variety. You know, like, Gears games have always been sort of road movies in the sense you're always on a journey from A to B. And the same is pretty true for 5, but we want to show, like, the variety from a, you know, jungle cenote to a frozen tundra to this sort of the red desert, like, all these different locations, and getting to visit some of the past, too. Some fans have already picked up on a few sort of Easter eggs in our trailer about some places you might go. And
nice.
Really excited to take the fans there.
And what about this skiff, this, like, across the frozen lake? Is that something you'll be able to use freely through the game? Or?
Yeah, it's not like the, you know, way we used to have the tank in Gears 2 and that kind of stuff. It's not meant to be just like, oh, it's you're driving down a hallway, essentially. Like, the thing about the skiff is that trying to open up the world and give you more choice of what you can do. And so the nice thing with the skiff being a wind, you know, wind is kind of our thing now with the wind flares and storms. And so we wanted to have a wind-powered vehicle that can go across different types of, and so you'll be able to take that skiff across the desert. You'll be able to take that skiff across the tundra.
Oh.
And so there's a lot of places you can go. It's great.
Excellent. Now, I want to talk about the scene that we just saw on screen a minute ago that you showed on stage yesterday, this amazing emotional scene.
Yeah.
Tell me about the way you approach motion capture and the way that you direct those scenes and the voice acting, everything, because it's next level stuff.
Well, thanks. Well, but it's new for us. You know, traditionally, we've always separated the two. We've always put motion capture has been separate from voice acting. But this time we wanted to take it up a notch and we wanted to actually do performance capture. And so we found like four or five scenes that we felt were critical to the game to have that sort of next level. And that was one of them, where Kate reveals that she has a secret about the Locust. And so what you're seeing now is this is Laura Bailey Kate. And so just wanted to do a little bit of side by side about how that we get that kind of performance out of our actors. It allows you to kind of really feel like the dialogue and the body motion is so in sync. And you really get that emotion to come out of it. And that's Greg Mitchell, who is our Cinemax director, who's fantastic. But these kind of things, like when trying to do that kind of collision where two bodies come together, like to animate that separately, or to, you know, like the fact that it worked in the moment where you've got both the voice performance and the motion performance together makes those things really, you know, sing. And so I'm really excited. I mean, a lot of games have been doing, you know, PCAP and a lot of movies and stuff, but it's brand new for us. And I think you can see the results in our trailer.
Absolutely. And I spotted you in the studio there as
well.
You take quite a hands-on approach with this side of the development of the game, right?
Yeah, it's kind of one of my passions. You know, I'm very involved in the story, so I'll edit all the scripts. And I'm working with, you know, Tom Bissell's our writer, the New York Times bestselling writer. And so I work with him and edit the scripts, and then I'll go and direct the VO, like when we do them separately. And then on the mocap stage, like Greg is, you know, he's really good at that. I don't want to get in his, like, but I work with him on that, and I make sure that the dialogue performance is what I'm looking for, or the way that they're saying the lines are what I want. But he's really good at, like, hey, I'm blocking for this shot, or I want this kind of view, and that's not my world. I don't think in terms of, like, what's inside the frame.
Yeah.
I think about what am I hearing, and am I getting the emotion across? And so we work together that way.
All right. What are you hearing from the Gears fans from the reveal yesterday, and when can they expect to see some more?
So the first part of that, it's been amazing. Like, Twitter blew up for me, and you know, Reset Era, we went onto the thread there, and just I was up till 3 this morning reading their 600 posts, you know, and it's been fantastic. Like, people are really supportive, and they understand what we're trying to do. You know, with Gears 4, we were really about establishing ourselves as a studio, you know, and like, okay, we only had 3 people who had ever made a Gears of War game before, so we're like, let's build a foundation, and let's prove that we can make a Gears game, and we did that with 4, and so now we're like, okay, you know, the what I call the commander's intent, like our vision statement, our mission statement for Gears 5 was challenge expectations, and right. So what can we do? And so we looked at it from a story perspective, at a gameplay mechanics perspective, from an art perspective, like how can we challenge? And so people are like, we're showing bits and pieces of it, and people are really getting that. They're saying like, oh, they're actually trying riskier things.
Great, great. And Gears Tactics was a big surprise yesterday as well, right? Tell us the direction there.
Yeah, it was just, it's been something that's been going on in the franchise, sort of bubbling underneath the surface for a long time. This idea, even when I was back at Epic, we had ideas around this idea of this sort of top-down, isometric. Because what's really interesting when you see Gears Tactics, it's actually like a concentrated essence of Gears. Like the things you think like cover and tactics and squad dynamics, like it's actually more Gears than Gears in a way, you know what I mean? And so I'm so happy we're able to do that now. And that was one of the things, you know, when as a creator, as a world builder, you go, what are the things that are stopping fans from getting into that world? And so you look at what are the barriers we can take away? And the obvious one is just platform. Like, okay, if everything's on console, then only certain people are going to get to play it, which is great. We love our console audience. We love our console game. But it's like, we want to broaden that. And how can we make it more approachable to more people? And so we go to mobile with Pop, and we go to PC with Tactics. And it's really just trying to be inclusive and trying to just make it, you know, open it up to the rest of the world.
Yeah, Gears Pop was possibly the funnest moment of the of the briefing yesterday.
Right.
Where did that come from?
It really, the idea of like, hey, let's do a mobile game really came from the publishing team. They were really like very passionate about, hey, we think this is something that's really cool. And but one of the things we were talking about is like, what style should we use? Like, what's the art style? What kind of way? And as we were thinking about it, I'm looking down at my desk, and there's my Funko Pop of Kate desk, and I'm like, you know, like they've already established an art style for Gears that works really well. It feels authentic. And so that's a big thing for us, is that we didn't want to be, oh, let's do a licensed match 3 game, or let's do this thing that just feels cheap. We wanted to create actual, authentic, you know, experiences, whether it's on mobile or PC or console. We want these things to feel like they belong on that platform. And so Gears Pop is very much a solid mobile game that you would play whether we had a Gears brand on it or not. Like, it's just a great game, and I love it. And we're working with great partners on those 2 games in terms of, like, obviously Coalition can't build 3 games at the same time, so we're working great dev partners. And I'm just really excited. Like, I'm already playing on my phone, and it's just fantastic.
Nice. Will you show me afterwards?
Oh, sure.
I can't wait to see it. Rod, always a pleasure, mate. Thanks. You so much for coming, and congrats on